the professor, the rabbi, the farmer. These were the wise men I met today on my way. And there was one more encounter that I wish to share with you. A gentleman stopped and said, "Are you okay?" As I was on the side of the road with my bicycle, taking a little bit of a breather, this man stopped and turned off his motorcycle to make sure that I was healthy, to make sure that I was safe, to make sure that I had water. A stranger providing me with those gifts is something sacred and simple. It's wonderful to think that a simple gesture can resonate so deeply. Something like water, which is life and death in the right circumstance, is also something that is part of our culinary and dietary and traditional masulti offering of water in the Middle East. This is something that is sacred and is a code of conduct that, even amongst enemies, to offer your foe a glass of water is a sign of endearment, of affection, of humanity, of empathy. You've fought hard, but you've lost. And I know what thirst is. It is something that we all experience as human beings. I hope that the knowledge that I was able to acquire this week can fill my heart and soul with more inspiration. I hope that my cup can be full and that I can also share the words with my audience, with you, with whoever's willing to listen, so that we can think about what it is that we do during the week and how we take the Sabbath day and make it sacred. Is it blessings and synagogues? Is it surfing and shetach? What is it that makes your Sabbath sacred? I ask you, and I think for myself the same question. Let's take this Shabbat to ponder and to wander, to stroll amongst the vineyards and the vines and the vinous vinifera that is growing here in Eretz Israel. For me, is part of my Sabbath ritual. I'm lucky to live in the village next to the fields, and those fields enable me to reconnect to the agronomist, with the ideas of the rabbi, with the wisdom of my friend the professor, and with the good fortune of those who stop on the path and on the way to offer us water. L'chaim, my friends, may the Sabbath be blessed.